joining me today. And today I have a friend of mine, Janine. She is here from the New American Theater. She's wearing her t-shirt. So we're going to be talking to her, having a little drink, and maybe sharing some chocolate and cookies.
Sounds delicious.
I know you have a sweet tooth.
I do. That's terrible.
I had a hard time deciding what to make Janine today. I texted her to ask her if she was allergic to anything, and she said shellfish, and I said, well, don't worry, I'm not going to make you drink any fishes.
Yeah, as long as there's no fish in the drinks, I'm good.
You're good. So, as you know, we showcase a business every week, and we try to do a little bit of Culver City-owned businesses, and Janine is a resident here in Culver City. And I want to ask you a little bit about your theater, and her husband's an actor.
Yes.
And so tell me how you got started with all of this, besides Jack being actor.
Yes, Jack Stalen, you might know him. He was, many people know him from his time on Weeds, but he also is the artistic director of the New American Theater, where I'm managing director. How I got started?
Uh-huh.
Oh, gosh. When I was young. No, I moved to Los Angeles, and I was very involved in theater in Chicago, and I moved here and wanted to continue doing theater, and I met Jack his very first day in Los Angeles.
Really?
And yes, he came in. We met him in a theater lobby of a live stage show.
And where was he from?
He was from New York.
Oh,
he had just spent 20 years in New York City working off-Broadway and on Broadway and at the New York Shakespeare Festival for any theater nerds out there. And so we met and we decided to work together, and he had a company called Circus Theatricals. And we've since changed the name to the New American Theater. But we started working together, and then 6 months later we decided that we liked each other. So, you know, we started
dating. And you guys
dating.
Make such a cute couple.
Oh, thank you.
And they make really beautiful daughters.
Oh, thank you. We have three teenage daughters. Little plug for them. Yeah. So now, 20 years later, mm-hmm. we have a theater company. We serve on the board of it, and we manage the New American Theater. And we produce live stage productions. Here, we rehearse over here in Culver City, the Veterans Memorial Auditorium, that building, anyone knows that building. And then we also just have our new space in Hollywood as well. So we're kind of, you know, spanning the scope of Los Angeles County.
So where is
the New American Theater? Okay.
Where is it located?
Our home base is Culver City, but our theater now is on Wilton Place, 1312 North Wilton Place in Hollywood. So go over there and visit us, and we do live stage performances, and we also run a professional actors training program, and we support new writers. So if there's any writers out there, we have our yearly, we do it twice a year, one act festival, where playwrights from all over the world submit their plays. And we had over 5,000 submissions internationally this year.
Wow. And do you judge?
We do. We have a literary committee of actors and volunteers, and every play gets read from cover to cover.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know I got some friends out there that write.
All right. Writers, newamericantheater.com.
Ray Ramos, come on. Okay, well, that's really wonderful to know. Do you have a production going on right now that anybody can go see?
Well, we have our ongoing actors training program, so we're training all year long, but right now we're getting ready. We just started rehearsals for, very timely, William Shakespeare's Measure for Measure. We're opening that in November, and then our Festival of New One-Act Plays also opens in November. We'll be doing five or six, we're planning on the sixth one, world premiere one-act plays featuring actors, professional theater actors from Los Angeles. And the plays are written by a combination of new writers and established writers.
Okay. Do we have any questions yet?
Monica says hi.
Hi, Monica. Thanks, Monica, for joining us today. And let me know if you have any questions out there for Janine. She is a world of information. She's also on the Cultural Affairs Commission here in Culver City. So, tell us, was that kind of like a little bit play into what you do already?
Yes, it actually does, and it's one of my passions is to support all kinds of art wherever we go, because I think art helps us understand each other better and mm-hmm. have a more thoughtful worldview. So I'm very lucky to be on the Cultural Affairs Commission, where this mm-hmm. year I'm chair, which is a great honor. And
tell them about some of the programs that you guys actually do in Culver City maybe they already put, you know.
Probably. So if you go around Culver City, and you might know there's public art. Public art is overseen by the city of Culver City, but the Cultural Affairs Commission also helps promote that art. So statues, the Lion Fountain downtown Culver City. If you go to a business and you see a waterfall, here's my impression of a waterfall, or a statue, or a painting. Here, painting. The Cultural Affairs Commission had some hand in that. And then also we have the Performing Arts Grant. And every year the Cultural Affairs Commission chooses, with help from the city, obviously, performing arts organizations to we pick their art and promote and help fund. So you'll see music in the chamber, you'll see concerts on the Baldwin Hills Overlook, you'll see productions in the Veterans Memorial Building, you'll see last year there were productions on Washington Boulevard in the Arts District. Those are many cases funded or partially funded by the City of Culver City and helped by the Cultural Affairs Commission.
So there's an Arts District something going on tomorrow we're participating in.
Good.
So our art will be there tomorrow.
I'll be there dancing.
You will?
Yeah, okay. Sure. You know.
So is that something that you did with the Cultural Affairs?
No, that's the Arts District doing that themselves. So of course, the city is also promoting it. But in addition to the Cultural Affairs Commission, there's also the City of Culver City Cultural Affairs Foundation, and if Jim Clark is watching, he'll be really happy that I mentioned it, because he's vice president.
Jim.
Yes. The Cultural Affairs Foundation is an organization that raises funds to support art in Culver City.
Gotcha.
Okay. And so look them up as well, because they are always looking for funders.
And tomorrow we'll be out there. It's on Washington Boulevard between Helms and La Cienega
or Fairfax.
Yes, what you said. Helms and Fairfax, and we look for Vita Cushion Raffia Jewelry. We'll be out there with our art, and Janine will be out there dancing.
Apparently, I'm really bad at it. No, I'm doing it.
But we're gonna be out there. I think it's from 12 to 6. So look for us and stop by and say hi. Okay, and. So today I decided to make Janine. Is there anything
else? We do have a question. What kind of jewelry do you like to dance in?
Jewelry. Anything that
flows.
Something that's not heavy on her
neck.
Something
not heavy. That's right.
Something light.
Yeah, hopefully that stays on. Yes.
Anything
else?
That's a funny question.
That is a funny
question.
Thank you
for that.
Any other questions? No, not yet?
Okay.
Well, while they ponder a question, today I decided to make a fall drink. I know we live in Southern California. It hasn't really felt very fallish to me until recently.
Yeah, autumnal yesterday.
A little bit. It's been a little humid. We had a little crazy rain. But, but otherwise, it really hasn't felt much like fall, so I thought, well, I'll try to make it feel like fall by having a little bit of a drink that was more like fall. So I'm making a bourbon maple apple cider. Before I make that, I chose some jewelry today. Janine came dressed in black. I'm, of course, wearing black as well. And
autumn colors,
right?
All we need is some
black
orange.
Goes in every season.
It does. We need a blue black kitten to walk by.
There you go.
It's almost Halloween.
Yeah, it's almost Halloween. So I decided to. I just went very simple today. I'm wearing an earring that I made, like literally one of the first earrings I ever made. They're kind of disco ballish, but
they're
dancing in some gray pearls and some labradorite and some a little black onyx. And
I love it.
It's great. Yeah, so she gorgeous. Can just, you know, layer and showing her how she can just do a little bit. Oh, and yes. Let's not forget about that beautiful bracelet.
That's gorgeous.
I made this bracelet a while ago. And it was designed and used on the runway for Sue Wong, who makes these beautiful beaded dresses. And she had commissioned me to make her all these pieces to go with her beaded jewelry, beaded dresses. And honestly, her dresses are gorgeous. So I was very honored to have made that.
I love this color, too. It's nice. It's like a silvery, like a moon color.
And it was so fun because those were the days when in our own little Culver City, we had these big, huge fashion shows at Smashbox Studios.
Oh, yeah.
And they were amazing. It was so much fun. And so that's where it was. Oh. And it was really nice. You know, one of the last ones that were there.
Well, thank you for letting me wear it.
Sure. So, and here I've actually just put out just a few, you know, like gold, very light pieces of jewelry. We were talking earlier about how your jewelry doesn't have to weigh you down, and these pieces can just be worn, like she's wearing three necklaces, but it's not weighing her down because they're all very light, and you can do that all day long without feeling like you've got this whole constraint going on in your neck, you know? And especially if you're working all day.
I was thinking about that because yesterday I wore a necklace that was really long and it kept hitting my desk.
Oh,
I was trying to type.
This is perfect. It's perfect because you can double it and everything.
Right.
So, the drink. I have in here a little bit of ice, my little shaker, and I'm going to put a little bit of maple syrup in here. Not too much, but half a thing. I don't want to make it too sweet. And I'm going to also put one of these measures of a good Kentucky bourbon. Apparently, only good bourbon comes from America?
I guess so. Let's go with it. Yes, only good bourbon comes from America. It's a fact.
It's a fact.
Oh, do you have one of these things above you?
Okay, and then I have some freshly pressed apple juice. Now you could do this with apple cider as well, but we've decided today to just do this apple juice. Yeah.
A little more
nice. So I'm going to take this and just sort of shake it up and get it nice and cold. And I bought these beautiful little glasses. They sort of remind me of fall, and they're I want to say they're probably from like the 60s.
Right, yeah. You might see it on grandma's table before she makes a highball.
Exactly.
Something my grandmother anyway.
So I got them at a flea market and I really like them. And so I thought I would use these on you today. And all I'm going to do is, smells good already. And for garnish, I'm just giving her a little cinnamon stick. Can you see it? And there you go.
Oh,
have a little taste
you.
Of okay. autumn.
Okay. All right. That's delicious.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Not, too. Oh, not getting you too drunk?
No, not yet.
We do have one more interesting question.
Yes.
It's, how can we use the arts as a way to reach common ground in our city amongst so much political tension?
Oh,
wow.
That's a loaded question and a good one for her.
Rafael, back to you. You know what? For those of you who do not know Janine, I'm going to be really cool about this question.
Yes, okay. She is. But she is also one of the leaders.
Have another drink before I answer this?
She is also one of the leaders of the Hearts
The Harvard Ballet Democratic Club.
Right. Mm-hmm. So you've come to the right place to ask a political question.
That's right. Well, thank you for mentioning that. We're the, and I didn't intend to do this, but we are a feminist democratic organization. The first one was established ever in LA County. in mm-hmm. 2 years ago. Yes. How can arts bring people together for common ground? Well, I'm a theater producer, so one thing that I like to do is try to present plays. I'll put this down.
Yes.
Try to present plays that have a universal theme but are also very personal to people. So when you look at a play, it might not specifically mention what's happening in the political realm, but it'll cause you to think. And what I love the most is when people who've witnessed a theatrical production or hear a piece of music or even see a piece of art or have dancers about them are living and breathing in the same room and are able to recognize each other or the people around them as human beings. And I think that if you're living and breathing together and recognizing the humanity in each other, then really interesting and surprising conversations can happen.
Thank you.
I hope I answered the question.
Mm-hmm.
I
think you did.
Yeah, you did.
Any other questions? No? Well, thank you everyone for joining us today. And this is Janine from the New American Theater. And go and see the theater, see your next play, which is Measure to Measure.
Measure for Measure.
Measure for Measure. Mm-hmm. And her husband is Jack Sterling, who also will be performing at the
movie. He is.
He's going to be in that?
Yes, okay. He's going to be.
Is he an evil guy? Is he not?
I don't know. Come find out.
And don't forget, if you do write and things like that, plays, whatever, submit.
Please do.
Submit to
newamericantheater.com. You'll find me.
Yay. All right. Thanks, everyone. And we'll see you next week. If you have any other questions, make a comment. And Janine is tagged on our FB Live and on our Instagram so she can answer any questions.
Beautiful.
Okay? Thank you. See you next week. Have a great weekend.